Hey everyone, David Turnbull here from Nintendo3DSblog.com. This is episode number one of This Week in Nintendo 3DS. Every week or so I'm going to just spend a few minutes talking about the latest Nintendo 3DS news. And in today's episode I'm going to just go through everything that we know about the 3DS, some of like the basic stuff and some of the stuff that you may not have heard of, but that is confirmed. Okay, so get the obvious stuff out of the way. Nintendo 3DS, it allows for 3D effects without any glasses. We're not exactly sure how that is done, but there are a few theories which I'll talk about in a future episode. But apart from that, we know that 3DS will be out before March 1st. So yes, this at the end of this financial year, the 3DS will be out by then. Although there are some rumors that it's out this year, but once again, that's for next episode. And then we have backwards compatibility with Nintendo DS and DSi games, which means, based on the fact that it's compatible with DSi games, that means the 3DS will still at least have two cameras. And then let's look at my notes. Okay, it's also been confirmed that you are able to turn the 3D effects off, which is a pretty big deal because there's been reports that 3D effects do have health issues, and there's obviously like eye strain if for some people, like 20% of the population, me included. So that'll be nice just if for a longer gaming session. And then Reggie, who is the president of Nintendo of America, has come out and said that this is a new generation of Nintendo handhelds. This isn't like the leap from the DSi to the DSi XL or anything. This is more like the leap from the Game Boy Advance to the DS. So this, you can expect quite a big leap in the processor speed and the look of the graphics and all that stuff. And then you've probably seen this video. Hopefully I've edited a video right there. And people have been wrongly assuming that that's how the 3D will look in the 3DS. That's actually a DSiWare game that you can just download right now, and that relies on head tracking, which is a software-based 3D effect. But Nintendo have confirmed that that isn't the effect that's going to be used, and so that's still a mystery of what they're going to use, but it's confirmed that it's not that. And in sort of a vague quote from Iwata, I think that's how you pronounce his name, or the CEO of Nintendo, it sounds like the 3DS will be a bit pricier than the current line of DSs, and most people are still estimating it to be around $180 to $200 at launch, although some people are saying it could be $250, but I doubt it would match the price of the Wii when it launched. And getting near the end here, Nintendo expects to sell about 3 million 3DSs I think by the end of the financial year. They didn't explicitly state this, but they released projections of 30 million sales by the end of the financial year, and previously, in the previous financial year, they sold 27 million, so it's obviously quite a big leap. So I'm pretty sure they're expecting to sell 3 million 3DSs. And finally, is that the fact that all the big announcements, still a month off or so, it's all coming around June 15th at Nintendo's E3 press conference, which I have plenty of information about on Nintendo3DSblog.com, and I will be posting links to live streams and all that good stuff right there. And that's pretty much it for now. There's not much else to report. In the next episode, I'm going to be talking about a bunch of the rumors and speculation that have already come out. That'll probably take two or three episodes to get through. And yep, that's pretty much it. Just a quick video here. Make sure you subscribe in iTunes or become a fan of the Nintendo 3DS on the Facebook page. And that's all good.